Our story begins in a small village in Austria-Hungary, an area known today as Czechoslovakia. The year is 1900. It's a poor little farm village, a place with not more than a dozen houses. It's where Sam Melton was born. 4 years later, however, a whole new life began.
Everywhere around the world, they come to America.
The first stop, New York's Ellis Island. From there, it was on to Toledo, Ohio, where Sam and his family would spend the next 15 years. Sam's father was a hard-working peddler, his mother, a generous, kind-hearted housewife. It was a happy home life for both Sam and his younger sister, Myrtle. After Sam graduated from high school in 1919, the family moved to Columbus, where his father bought a grocery store. Sam worked in the store while at the same time pursuing a degree in accounting at Ohio State University. Upon graduation from Ohio State, Sam went to work as an accountant at a relative structural steel business in Cleveland. While there, he came up with an idea for a new business: manufacturing pipe nipples, pieces of pipe with threads on both ends. In 1925, he opened Capital Supply Company here in Columbus, later to be called Capital Manufacturing. And the rest is pretty much history. The business became a monumental success, and the boy who was born in that poor European village became very rich and very generous. Sam's giving really began at Tiferet Israel in 1925, but it quickly spread through Columbus, across the country, and to Israel. Sam established the first American plant in Tel Aviv and gave the profits to Hebrew University and other organizations in Israel. Here at home, Sam made possible the Esther C. Melton Community Services Building in memory of his late wife. He donated a library at Bexley High School in memory of son Michael. And the list of donations goes on and on. Jewish education has long been one of Sam's primary interests.
The real means of survival of Judaism is educating your children.
With that goal in mind, Sam established the Melton Research Center at the Jewish Theological Seminary in New York, the Melton Center for Jewish Studies at OSU, the Samuel and Esther Melton Vocational High School in Israel, Boys Town, Jerusalem, with the help of wife Florence, the Florence Melton Adult Mini School for Jewish Education at Hebrew University, and a list of grants and scholarships too numerous to mention. Sam Melton's giving is not only extensive, it's widespread, ranging from United Jewish Appeal to the United Negro College Fund. He has been a consistent leading giver to the annual campaign, to Heritage House, the Leo Yasinoff Jewish Center, OSU, and Jewish Family Services. From around the world to here at home, Sam Melton demonstrates so well what the Columbus Jewish Foundation is all about. He's been on the foundation board since its beginning, demonstrating true leadership and serving as an example for all of us.
You must help your neighbor. That's the philosophy, the background of my philanthropy, I might say.
I think what we learn from the life of Sam Melton is that an individual can make a tremendous contribution through his own work and through motivating others to work with him and giving others the resources to work with him.
He's a person who would identify a need and then go ahead and fulfill that need. He would support the need.
He wants the best value for his dollar that he donates, and he sees to it that it's usually gotten. He doesn't just give and walk away.
He's never lost his basic humility, and he's never lost his dedication to his neighbors, the people he grew up with. I'm talking about our community. Not only the Jewish community, but the entire community. I think he's been so loyal to it, you know, and demonstrated time and time again because he had the means to do it.
When somebody gives without looking for the honor of giving, and without looking for recognition, that to me is a great person.
He requires no repayment for his investment and takes great joy in the fact that others have recognized his sincerity, his involvement in the quality of life for other people. And I believe he has set an example for many, many young people in our community and throughout the world.
The only advice I can give to anybody is what I said. You've got to do the best you can. And when you're successful and fortunate, you should be helping others.